Hojin and Shurin. Thank you for being with us today. I first want to say that our hearts and good wishes are with everyone whose lives have been affected by this terrible pandemic, and we wish you all good health. This pandemic, I think, has shown us how interconnected we are with each other and how important it is for us to support each other in these difficult and uncertain times. Music, whether a form of entertainment or a cultural brand and the bread and butter of a country, becomes a source of solace and unity for many people. And we hope to continue our mission at the Mavs Sinfonico Zenekar of providing exactly that to our beloved and supportive audiences. So I wanted to tell you that I'm super excited to present our 2020-2021 season that is truly the best of musical selections and international artists. Of course, we have no idea what will happen in the next few months, but we are hopeful. And in times when, in this situation, office workers were able to continue their work, either in an office or from home, for us performing artists of any genre, not just music, has been very scary silence that we just don't know how to deal with. And we are hopeful and we wait for this pandemic to finish, hopefully with a vaccine or something that will help us survive this and go forward. But nonetheless, we have to think of the future as if nothing has happened and as if music is going to continue to give us nourishment for the soul. So let me tell you about the season. It's quite exciting. At the Zene Academia, where we do most of our concerts, the orchestra and I will present such adored masterpieces as Holst's The Planets, Elgar's Enigma Variations, Prokofiev's Fifth Symphony, Mussorgsky's Pictures and Exhibition, and a commissioned work that George already mentioned by, or maybe you didn't mention, I'm not sure, by Ayrat Ishmuratov. He's a Tatar-Canadian composer, very acclaimed, doing very well. He wrote a special piece for our 75th birthday called The Dream of Turun, incorporating Hungarian folklore into the music. And I'm very excited and hopeful that we will be able to give the world premiere. We will collaborate with such renowned soloists as violinist Kirill Trusov playing the Bruch Concerto, the Arthur Rubinstein laureate pianist Daniel Chubanu playing Prokofiev's Third Concerto, cellist Gustav Rivinius playing rarely heard Shostakovich's Second Concerto, a wonderful piece, and Israeli violinists, Itai Shapira and Hagai Shaham, performing Shapira's own concerto for two violins called Magyar, his celebration of Hungary's influence and significant contribution to the world of music. We will also host several guest conductors, such as Christoph Campestrini with Mahler's Sixth Symphony, Kesheyak Gege conducting an opera gala of works by Puccini and Corbo, and principal guest conductor Chaba Peter featuring violinist Andrei Baranov with Beethoven's Violin Concerto, and Szabadi Vilmos with Hubai's rarely heard Third Concerto. And I love this composer. I didn't know about this composer until this past season when I heard Szabadi Vilmos play some chamber music of his, and really wonderful. And when I heard he's going to play a concerto by this composer, I was very excited. And that will be with conductor Takács Nagy Gábor, featuring also pianists Jean-Efflam Bavouzé and Andrea Nemetz in Mozart's double piano concerto, which is always very exciting because when you're sitting in the audience and you see two pianos, on the stage. It's double the fun. We continue celebrating our 75th birthday, that was cut short by this pandemic last season, by inviting many of our former chief conductors, including Gal Tamás, in a program of Schumann's Second Symphony and Brahms' Third Symphony, and Kolar Imre, he's also a former chief, in an all Beethoven program celebrating Beethoven's 250th birthday, which is still going until 2021, featuring pianist Ranki Dezsö, playing the fourth concerto, and the fourth concerto is a very special one. Hello. We know number three, we know number five, those are super famous. Number four is also famous, but it's just so introspective and beautiful, and how maybe for the first time in history, I'm not completely wrong about this, that the piano starts on its own without an orchestral prelude or introduction. The piano starts, and with these introspective, sad or maybe nostalgic chords. So that's a very exciting concerto that we will perform. At the MUPA, at the Bartok National Concert Hall, the orchestra and I will present exciting pieces such as Bartok's Miraculous Mandarin and Shostakovich's Fifth Symphony. And we look forward to welcoming back violinist Maxim Vengerov with Shostakovich's violin concerto. We are very proud and honored to celebrate Bartok's 140th birthday with a gala concert featuring the world-renowned violinist and violist Pinchas Zukerman and his wife and incredible cellist Amanda Forsyth. And Kodály's duo, and Pinchas is going to play Bartok's viola concerto. That's a rare treat. We continue to celebrate Beethoven's 250th birthday with Misa Solemnis, conducted by Kovács János. I don't know if you know that I used to be a singer before I became a conductor, and one of the highlights as my life as a singer was singing Misa Solemnis. It's just one of the most incredible pieces in the whole repertoire. And when you have a large choir singing together and you're engulfed in these sounds and these voices, it's a once-in-a-lifetime experience. But experiencing it from the audience side is also quite fantastic. As you've heard from George the past season, our special Jubilee concert to mark the 75th birthday was canceled on April 30th due to the pandemic, but we are going to repeat it do it for the first time. It's a redo, as we say it in English. It's a redo, and so exciting to have Charles Dutoit conduct Beethoven's Ninth. This is a rare artist, the way he works with the orchestra, the way the orchestra loves him, the kind of sounds, the kind of atmosphere he can bring out of the musicians. We are super, super lucky to have him be a friend of this orchestra. We also have a series of four concerts at the Italian Institute, ranging in music from Beethoven and Rossini to Dinico and Brahms, with conductors Denis István, Hölöpő Huba, José Eduardo Gómez, and myself included, featuring double bassist Patkolo Román, our principal oboist Körösi Miklós, cellist Mihály Rió, and violinist Elias David Moncado, and pianist Ilya Fripek. What I love about the Italian Institute is that this is a place for us to feature soloists, conductors, and repertoire that you might not regularly see. Either the conductors are young, or the soloists are young and just starting their career, or the repertoire is something that doesn't usually go on a big stage, and it's just an opportunity to surprise yourselves with new things and be pleasantly surprised after every concert, and that is a promise. What else do we have? Yes, we have a series of four concerts at the more intimate setting of the Festetic Palace. This is a very, very beautiful, beautiful room where we perform. Most of the time you spend looking at the walls and at the chandeliers while listening to the music because it's that beautiful. For me, it's always a wonderful experience. But we are going to feature very much loved works such as Massenet's Meditation with our concertmaster violinist Barta Matyash, Bruch's Kol Nidre with our own principal cellist Roja Richard, Bach's Ricercar with oboist Lenches Lajos, Mozart Concertone with violinist Alexander Zhunchevsky and Mikhail Weiman, self-conducted, and Mozart's fifth violin concerto with Kelemann Gaspar, conducted by Tapet Nagy-Gábor, our principal conductor. And last but not least, we include the smallest of humans in our activities, who are always happy to listen to good music ranging from ballet to symphonic. A series of four concerts for grandchildren and grandparents presented by our own flutist, Sekeri Edith, as well as former member of the orchestra and is he chairman of the board now? Fenio Gabor. Yes. And trumpeter Seidel Danish Mihai. Secondly, Edith is also a music educator, and she presents also a series of four concerts aimed at small children ranging in ages from 3 to 6. So there you have it. In general words, a very exciting season with so many wonderful artists and great repertoire. In these times, I think we are hungry for live music, really hungry for it. It's nice to watch on television all kinds of translations of concerts, but nothing replaces live performances, and this food for the soul, I think, is going to do us a lot of good. So I would like to thank the entire administration team for working so hard during the pandemic in organizing such an exciting and eventful season for our audiences who are thirsty for this live music. We're all very much looking forward to emerge from this musical quarantine, and hope to see so many of you with us at the concerts. Thank you all very much for coming.